speed. Live it.
Now you're watching gear.
You know, 30 years ago, in 1977, a movie came out that just absolutely blew everybody's mind. It was called Star Wars, and people just went crazy for it. The problem is, if you were a car guy, Star Wars didn't really have much to offer you. Matter of fact, in 1977, there wasn't a lot to offer anywhere. People were listening to disco and they were wearing polyester clothing and the cars. Oh, slow and ugly. Then, in the late summer of 77, another movie came out, and it knocked Star Wars off the top of the heap. Now, this was basically a modern-day Western with a good-hearted bandit running from the law. But he didn't ride a horse. No, he drove a car, a Trans Am to be exact, and it was black. And in 77, you either had this car or you wished you did, because it changed popular culture as we know it.
Honey, hush.
This movie introduced people to modern country music and southern culture. It started the CB craze. It had people walking around saying things like Son and Cletus. And it had some of the best car stunts ever put on film. Yeah, the movie was called Smokey and the Bandit.
Smokey and the Bandit was a hoot.
I'm the brother of a truck driving mother. Boogity, 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 boogity.
It was a party.
Daddy, the top came off.
No.
Jackie Gleason was just eating them alive.
Do you know who you're talking to?
Sheriff.
Do for justice.
Let me have a Diablo sandwich of Dr. Pepper. Make it fast. I'm gonna hurry.
Hey, boy.
Boy, it was a cartoon.
Let's go that way. The evidence in the car.
Bank robbing is big alongside of what this dude is doing.
As soon as I get home, the first thing I'm gonna do is punch your mama in the mouth.
Oof. How's that behind this?
We're having fun yet.
Now, it goes without saying that Smokey had some incredible actors in it. Burt Reynolds and Jerry Reed and Jackie Gleason and Sally Field. But every gearhead knows that the real star of the movie was the black Trans Am, because it did things that no normal car should be able to do.
So I called Pontiac and made a deal with them. They gave me 3 Trans Ams and 2 Bonnevilles for the sheriff. Believe me, when we got through, we were stealing parts off of this and this and this to make the last one run. I mean, we just barely got through.
And all we did was go out and wreck cars. That's all we did, was went out and wrecked a bunch of cars. Every time that Trans Am did a stunt, they had to pack it off and bring in another Trans Am. Oh, it'd bend the frame, you know, tear it up.
So why was it so popular? What was it about this movie that made it have such a huge impact on our popular culture? Well, the muscle car era was long gone. And anyone with a passion for cars was kind of looked down on. Matter of fact, every time you turned on the news, there was another oil embargo or a fuel shortage or some crooked politician doing something.
People have got to know whether or not their president's a crook. Well, I'm not a crook.
Yeah, no question. We had forgotten how to have fun. And then along comes this black Trans Am. all these crazy characters.
Come on, this is abandoned.
This here is the grave robber.
The good witch of the north, Foxy Lady.
Silver tongued devil.
This is Sheriff George Bradford.
This is Little Beaver.
You got the one snowman on me. He's bound and down.
All of a sudden, we're all laughing again.
I think I just went 10-100.
And that's nothing but pure and simple old-fashioned communism.
Now, in spite of what you remember from the movie, the late 70s Trans Ams were not that fast, with a 400 cubic inch motor and around 220 horsepower. But for a production car in the late 70s, that was about as good as you could get. And that's what made the timing for Smokey and the Bandit so perfect. Not only was the front nose new for 77, but also the black and gold paint scheme was new for a production Trans Am. Of course, the car carried all the typical markings of 70s automotive excess, like wheel flares and T-tops and a CB radio, and of course that big bird on the hood. Of course, now, 30 years later, the big question is, what happened to the car from the movie? Well, according to director Hal Needham, there were three cars used in the movie, and they were all destroyed during filming. Matter of fact, one of them was totaled during the bridge jump. That's why you never see the landing very well.
The jump across the bridge. Wipe that one off. It's gone. All we just scavenged parts off of that thing. And time we got to the last shot, we were barely had a car running.
But the good news is there are thousands of these old Trans Ams out there waiting for you to make a project out of it. And they're still affordable. So if you want one, you can get one. Now, of course, if you want one of these cars that will actually do what the car in the movie did, that's going to take a special Trans Am. And that's what we're going to look at next. Today, we are recognizing the 30th anniversary of one of the most influential cars and car movies of all time, Smokey and the Bandit, and the black and gold Trans Am. Now, we've already walked you through the cultural impact that this car and that movie had on everybody back in 77. But what about today? I mean, what if you could take a classic Trans Am and bring it up to today's standards? You know, to where it would run with Corvettes and Vipers. What would that car be like? Well, the guys at Year One have done just that. In what they call the Burt Reynolds Edition Bandit Trans Am. And what we've got here is the very first Bandit 3. Now, Year One said that we could take you for a spin in it as long as we promise to treat it with loving care and not scratch it. And that is what this is for. I love these black cars.
Better invest in some touch-up paint.
The Year One Burt Reynolds Trans Am, at first glance, may look like a stock 77 Trans Am, but that's the whole point. It's supposed to have all the look and the attitude of the original Bandit car without revealing how nasty this car really is under the skin. From a styling standpoint, the changes are subtle but significant. The front and back glass are all flush mounted for a more contemporary look. The nose houses modern projector beam lights without losing the original feel of the car. The wheel flares are redesigned for a better fit, and the wheels are a modern 18-inch billet interpretation of the original snowflake design. Now those wheels are wrapped in 10-inch wide rubber in the front and huge 12-inch rubber in the rear. That'll help this thing hold the road around corners and when you stomp the gas, which is going to be a challenge for this car.
The proper Bandit launch is about 3,000 to 4,000 on RPM. See there? See where we're sitting? Got your clutch down here, and you got your shifter, and you... Oh, yeah!
Now, when Year One decided to build a car to this level, well, they knew it would have to handle. And not just well, no, it'd have to be up to the standards of the hottest performance cars on the road today. So the suspension was stuffed with tubular subframe, control arms, rack and pinion steering, subframe connectors, performance shocks, a four link in the rear. Yeah, all the good stuff. So does it work? Yeah, this thing handles better than any second generation Firebird you'll ever see. And with huge calipers and rotors front and rear, she'll stop in a hurry too. I need another Sharpie. Did you bring a spare? Of course, the big question is the engine. What is it? That's a 600 horse LS7 that just gets up and screams when you lay into it. Now, behind that is a Tremec TK05 speed. That's just a pleasure to drive when you start busting through the gears. Then there's the hood scoop. Now, obviously, it's functional. And when you stomp the pedal and you see that scoop rock sideways, man, it's something every gearhead should experience. Is this cool or what? But all that burning rubber and flying gravel does come at a cost to Year One. The interior, all business, with special black and gold leather seats holding you in place. The dash has all been reworked with modern gauges. And of course, the console and the door panels hold the pedigree that so many people are after. Now, one thing that you won't see on most supercars is a roll cage that's so nicely blended into the interior that it's very easy to overlook. Once again, that's the purpose here. To give you all the performance and safety of a modern supercar and still retain the look, the feel, and the attitude of the original legendary car. Well, there it is, the Burke Reynolds Edition Bandit Trans Am from Year One. Now, obviously, this is not a cheap car, but obviously, it is not your average car either. No, this is a supercar in every sense of the word. And if you're lucky enough to buy one of these, your biggest concern is not going to be somebody outrunning you. Oh, no. Your biggest concern is going to be keeping enough Sharpies on hand to hide the evidence.
The evidence in the car!
You know, whenever a bunch of